the Recovery Act was announced and we learned that NIH was going to receive over 2 years, $10 billion to spend on advanced medical research, we started very quickly putting into place new programs for investigators to send in their most innovative ideas. We would guess somewhere in the neighborhood of 50,000 jobs coming out of this circumstance. And on top of that, all of the money that goes into NIH-supported science multiplies itself because those investigators, they need supplies and they need equipment. And most of those supplies and equipment are made in the U.S. And so an analysis would tell you that within 1 year, a dollar of NIH funding is actually produced more than $2 worth of economic goods and services from the overall economy. It's a very good investment to try to get our economy going again. There's never been this opportunity at a moment in history to really turbocharge the whole enterprise, and that's what the Recovery Act has made possible.
Johns Hopkins Health System actually hires about 55,000 people in the state of Maryland, and the School of Medicine actually has 13,000 employees. With the increase, we actually have done a job fair over the summer, early summer, to really brace for this influx of new talent to really take the research dollars to take it to the next level. Because of the investment that's been done, scientists really have been able to really get to the new, you know, body of knowledge, and we're ready to apply this.
And now the questions come. How do we handle this much information? We got the news last winter that we would be receiving the ARRA money and knew that the road was ahead. We didn't have to slow down this caravan.
We are at a unique moment in terms of scientific opportunity. A number of things have happened in the last 3 or 4 years to make advances in cancer and heart disease and diabetes and mental illness and a long list of other conditions possible at a pace that we couldn't have dreamed of a few years ago. But we were limited in terms of resources. The Recovery Act provides the opportunity at just the right moment, because the science has gotten us there, to really accelerate the discovery process and the way in which that's going to affect the ability to diagnose and prevent and treat diseases.
This project needed an additional year for the three first tumors, brain, ovarian, and lung cancer. And it turned out the way the project timetable has played out to get the most robust data, we needed that extra year. And with these funds, this allows many, many workers to provide us the data that we need to chew on to do this part of the cancer genome project. And so all of these individuals keep working during that year and doing this for the cancer genome project.
This particular stimulus really not only is stimulating job retentions and creation, but I think you're going to see some real significant science being done, because there was just pent-up demand for funding to really cross that barrier to make new discoveries.
Every one of the 50 states is receiving monies from one source or another for one grant or another, and many of them getting lots and lots of support for this. It includes students, it includes other people in training, it includes technicians who maybe have a master's degree or maybe a college degree or maybe a community college degree who do special technical work. It includes all of the support staff, the people who do the ordering, who maintain the databases. It includes computer scientists who are trying to keep track of all the data that gets generated in these huge projects. This is not business as usual. This is really pushing the frontiers forward in dramatic ways.